This video is the ultimate RetroPie 4.1 Raspberry Pi tutorial, and I'm going to show you how to install, upgrade, and transfer ROMs with ease. So the first thing you're going to want to do is go to retropie.org.uk. Once there, you'll need to click on the Get RetroPie button. On this page, you'll need to choose either Raspberry Pi 0 or 1 or Raspberry Pi 2 or 3. Click on your version of Raspberry Pi to start downloading the image. The next thing you'll need to do is download the program Etcher. This will allow you to write the image directly to your micro SD card. Links are in the description. Open up Etcher and then select the image. Now select your correct device. If you choose the wrong one here, you could be overwriting another hard drive or USB stick. Lastly, click Flash, and after about 3 minutes, your image will be finished writing and will automatically unmount. Over to the Raspberry Pi now, and with your first run, the system will resize itself and then reboot once. After about a minute of loading, the screen will come up telling you that emulation station has started, and then we'll see the welcome screen. Now here what you'll need to do is you'll need to press a button and hold it down on your gamepad so it recognizes it. This particular configuration is meant for an Xbox 360 or a PS3 or PS4 controller, so press each button as it comes up, and then once you're done, hit OK. Now that we're inside RetroPie, we'll go down to RetroPie Setup. This is where we can upgrade and update our RetroPie Setup. Once in here, what we'll need to do is go down to Update All Installed Packages. Choose Yes, and be prepared to spend about 30 minutes waiting for this to go through and fully update. Even though it doesn't seem like it, eventually it will finish and you'll get to this screen here. Hit OK and go all the way down to the bottom and perform a reboot. Don't forget to choose Yes. Once your system has performed a full reboot, what you'll need to do next is go into the RetroPie setup again, and this time we're going to install an experimental package. So to do this, what we'll need to do is we'll need to go down to Manage Packages, and then all the way down the bottom to Manage Experimental Packages. Here you might notice a few interesting little tidbits like Drastic, the Nintendo DS emulator. There's also Virtual Jaguar there and a track mode. But what we want is about second from the bottom, so make sure you go right down to the very bottom. Click on RetroPie Manager and then click on Install. This will go through now and quickly install the RetroPie Manager, which will be accessible through a web browser. Once it's finished installing, go down to Configuration and Options. Here we can enable RetroPie Manager to start upon each boot, and also once we've done that, we can make it start right now. Now before we go any further, what we need to find out now is we need to find out what our Raspberry Pi's IP address is. And to do this, it's really simple on RetroPie. Once you're back to this configuration menu, all you need to do is go down to Show IP. Make sure you write this down because we are going to need it after we've finished here back on the computer. Now let's pop over to the PC and let's open up a web browser. So to access RetroPie Manager from your web browser, you need to go to your IP address followed by :8000. Here you can monitor things like your CPU, your memory, temperature, etc., and how much space is left on the device. But one of the best features of RetroPie Manager is the ability to upload BIOSes and ROMs directly from your browser. So to show you how this process works, what I'll do is I'll upload a ROM right now. So I'll go and choose the system, and that'll be the Nintendo Entertainment System, and I will also choose a ROM, which is one of my favorites of all time, Super Mario Bros. 3. Now to save space on the device, what I'm going to do is I'm going to upload the zip file instead of the .nez file. Now the reason for this is that it will save about 100 kilobytes, and that doesn't sound like a lot, but when you've got a small SD card, every kilobyte counts. So you simply just drag and drop your ROM straight onto the web page and it will upload it and do all the rest. Now before you'll see the ROM appear in RetroPie, what we'll need to do is we'll need to restart Emulation Station. And to do that, all we need to do is press Start on the gamepad, go down to Quit, and go to Restart Emulation Station. Once we're back up, we'll see that Nintendo Entertainment System is in the list. So now we can go into Nintendo Entertainment System and choose Super Mario Bros. 3. And another quick tip in case you're not aware, once you're in there and you're playing the game for a little bit and you want to quit and get back to RetroPie, all you need to do is hit Start and Select at the same time, hold them in, and that'll get you straight back into RetroPie. If you enjoyed this video, then make sure you subscribe to my channel and also make sure you hit the little bell icon too so you get notified of any new videos that I release. And as always, imagine, learn, create.